Right now, I'm going to show you how to create a brush from a photograph and use it in Photoshop. So we're going to build a double exposure effect with this woman. First thing we want to do is quickly cut her out. So let's grab our magic tool. And then when we do that, enables select subject. So let's choose select subject. And I'm just hit Control J. And it's just going to copy her to a new layer. So let me just fill this with just some kind of a solid colors, just fill it with white underneath. And this is just going to give us a base to work off. All right, what we want to do now is we want to put something on top. All right, let's grab this tree and we're going to use this as our texture for our double exposure. So we're going to drag this into the tab of the image of the woman. So we're combining the two images. Notice that the cursor is black and solid. That's because it's loaded. Now I release it. And we can see we've dropped that tree in behind her. It looks kind of cool behind her. But what we want to do is we want to put it above her. And we want to clip it inside the shape or the silhouette. So if I hold down the Alt or the Option key, when I go between the two layers, you'll see an arrow. Click. And now we can drop this into that area. And we get an interesting kind of a effect. Now if we want this to be more of a double exposure, we take the top layer and we change it to screen. So let's take the blend mode. We're going to change this to screen. And now we can see how the two are working together. What I'm going to do though is I'm going to hit the Control L for levels. And I want to brighten this up just a little bit. So I'm pushing that brightness so that we can start to see how it's going to actually cut it out and get more of an interesting effect. Okay. So the challenge we have here now is look at the silhouette. The silhouette is just the woman and the trees are not really having much of an effect. So we want to create a tree style silhouette. We want little branches on the edges to make it more interesting. This is where we create a brush and we can use a brush. So I'm going to use this photograph of this tree and we're going to generate a brush from it. So the first thing you do when you create a brush is you want to make a strong contrast. So right now we've got gray and we've got black. When we create the brush, that gray is not going to give us that pure transparency or that white. So we're going to hit Control L, Command L on the Mac, brings up levels. So we want to make this pure white. So take the white slider, pull it in until it becomes a pure white. There we go. Now, this is starting to gray out a little bit. We want it to be stronger, so let's force this to black. So we're going to take the black triangle, pull it in, and notice that gives us a stronger silhouette. Now we can refine it with the middle. With that middle tone, notice how we can pull that up and get a really nice effect there. Just watch that these don't sneak back to gray. If they do, take the white and just push it in a little bit more, and we get a nice clean silhouette. That's what we're looking for. Click OK. Now, this is just going to end with these blocky edges. We don't want blocky edges. We want a very smooth brush. So what we're going to do is we're going to create a new layer. And then we're going to add some white. So let's set the foreground color to white. Click on the foreground swatch and select white. Or just hit the D key for default and then the X key. That's another way to get to white. Now we're going to grab a gradient. Now under the gradient tool, we're going to use the color here is the foreground to transparent, which is white to transparent. Make sure that we're using linear, normal, and 100% opacity. So we want to start where the details end, and we're just going to drag this up. And notice as we do this, it gets rid of everything, and it gives us a nice kind of area here where we're just kind of smoothly blending. In fact, we could go even more, and we're smoothly, slowly blending here into this texture. So we're not going to get a harsh edge. Now, if you've got a little bit of an edge at the top, we can touch that up as well. Let's just hit the B for the brush, and we're just going to grab a... So we're just going to grab a hard-edged brush to make sure that hardness is all the way up. Let's take the size down a little bit, and maybe take the size down a little bit more. Great. And now we can just paint with white to make it look like these branches sort of end there. So we're not going to get this squared off edge because that would just ruin your brush. So let's just quickly do that. All right, so it kind of looks like the branches are just kind of naturally ending there now. Let's define our brush. All right, let's make a selection with the marquee tool. And we're just going to select around the area that we want to create a brush from. this will work nicely. Let me just drag it to the edge. Let's choose Edit. And we're going to choose Define Brush Preset. And here we go, we're creating a sample brush. It's going to be 4800 pixels. It's actually going to maintain the same size that we created. So it's a high resolution brush that can be used for a lot of things. So let's call it Branches. Click OK. All right, so we've created our brush, but not only that, by default, when we create the brush is going to be selected. And if we click here in the brushes panel, you'll notice here's the brush. Here's some previous ones I've been playing around with. So you can see that that's going to remain inside our brush library. So we can select that anytime just by clicking there. Great. All right, let's go back to our layer that we're working on. So how can we influence this, you know, to create these nice edges that we want on this? So we want to add it to the silhouette. Now, what I'm going to do, though, is I'm going to create a new layer. So let's create a layer above. And right now, everything is kind of clipping to that layer. Let's unclip it. I'm going to hit the Alt or the Option key, and that's click, and it's going to unclip everything. So what we want to do is just have this clip to the layer underneath. So let's hold it between this top layer, the texture, and our layer underneath, and now it's going to clip. This is going to enable us to see what's happening. Right now, nothing's showing because we haven't painted anything yet. Let's grab our brush. We're going to start with a black brush. So we're choosing black. We've got our brush selected, and of course, we don't see our brush. And that's because the brush is massive. If we hit the left bracket key, we can actually make it smaller. Right bracket key will make it bigger. Excellent. So now we can see where it is. Now we want to have a little bit of flexibility with this. Let's open up the brushes panel. So let's click on the brush, brush settings pop open. We're concerned with the brush tip shape. So we can rotate our brush here. We can of course change the size here, and we can also flip the X or Y. So let's do that right now. What we want to do is we want to build up these edges with this new brush, but we don't want it to look obvious or repeating. So let's just use the bracket keys to make it a little bit smaller, and let's rotate them. Left bracket key, by the way, will rotate the brush. Right bracket key will rotate it the other way. If you hold down the shift key, we can do it much quicker, and then this will save us a bit of time so we can see what's going on here. Great. So now I'm just going to click. Now notice as I clicked, it created the texture of that brush, and because this is clipped in here, it's going to start to fit in there. Great. So let's do it a little bit smaller. So we want to kind of mix it up a little bit. And we're starting to add these around the edges. Now, let's flip this, the X, and then what that's going to do is it's just going to flip it upside down so it's not so repetitive when we're working with this. If you want a truly great result, sometimes you could actually go in and spend a bit more time and create more than one brush. But for this case, we're just going to use one brush, and this should explain how everything works. Let's add that. Let's flip it over. So we're going to hit the flip Y, which is going to make it go the other way now. You see how we're starting to build up this texture along the edge. Now the interesting thing is because of the way the masking is working, because we're painting with black, it's not giving us a black edge, it's giving us the texture coming through underneath. So it's just adding a silhouette. So what we want to do now is we want to just kind of merge this with the other image, because notice how we've got the screen mode, it's working on the edge, but it's not working inside the photograph anymore. If we want the whole thing to work together, just select the two layers, right click, and we convert to a smart object. As soon as we do that, now we get our screen mode working in there, and look at the silhouette starting to blend beautifully and smoothly in here. Now we can reposition our top layer just by selecting it. We can move it around. And as we reposition it, it's going to fit within that clipping area until we get something that's kind of, you know, maybe a little bit more what we're looking for. So we can even have these branches coming through. Gives us a lot of kind of fun. So then we've got the natural colors. There's other things we can do. We can apply colors on top if we want. So if, say, for example, let's create a solid color. And we want to give it some kind of a greenish hue. Let's take it there so it's not so highly saturated. Change this to color blend mode. And you can see now we get a monochromatic. If we want to reduce the opacity a little bit, we can start to blend those colors together. Now we just can keep compositing and adding components and stuff like that. I played around a little bit and this is the result that I came up with, just based on the same technique of using that brush. So I hope you found this tutorial useful. If you did, drop a comment underneath. Let me know what you learned and also what you'd like to learn. Drop any questions or anything like that. If you're new, welcome to Photoshop Cafe. Hit that subscribe button, turn on notifications. You won't miss any of my tutorials. Do me a favor, hit the like button. It helps us with the YouTube algorithm. Until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.